Hi there, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Random Geek channel. And today we're going to do something a bit special. And as you can see, I'm on the Tesla Australia website. So I'm a little bit afraid, a little bit scared, and excited at the same time because I'm going to bite the bullet and order a Tesla Model 3. So this is probably the most expensive thing that I've ever purchased online. So besides my Well, this is the most expensive thing I've ever bought. So one of the good things about COVID, well, not one of the good things, one of the consequences of the coronavirus pandemic is I have not been able to travel for the last 2 years. So no family holidays, no nothing. And that has led me to be able to save up a little bit of cash. And I am in need of a new vehicle. So I thought I'll bite the bullet, and me and my wife have decided to go or battery electric vehicle, which is strange given in Australia, EVs have been very, very slow to pick up. And that's because EVs are really, really expensive in Australia. And also there are no government incentives to buy an EV, so there's no tax break, there's no subsidy, there is nothing, literally. Unfortunately, we do have a government who is really enamored with coal and natural gas, and we don't even have emission targets in Australia. And yeah, and EVs have not launched very well in Australia. And very, very few EVs, like driving around, you will barely see any on the road. But that number is increasing, and I believe that Australia will find its way, and we will fully embrace this like we have embraced pretty much everything else. So we're hopping onto the site, and as you can see with the prices, yeah, the prices are as listed, but remember, these are just the prices that you will start off with. And as always, when you're configuring a Tesla, you can add extra features on. And remember, we do have tariffs, GST, when you include the on-road costs and registration, pretty much this number will add up relatively quickly. And as you can see, that the standard range plus in Australia is 66,900. That's the base price. The expected driveway price is down the bottom here, and expected to be just a tad under 72,000 Australian dollars. So when I hear people in Europe, United States and China, and they purchase their Model 3s for a certain price, to put that in perspective for my American viewers, basically the same price you get a standard range plus in Australia is the same price that you would probably pay for a fully spec'd out Model 3 performance. So that's the difference. And given that the Australian dollar has risen dramatically over the last year, I think we're at roughly 80 cents to the Australian dollar now, to the US dollar. So yeah, you do have to pay through the nose. I could understand that when we were getting our cars from Fremont, but now since all the Model 3s are launching from Tesla Shanghai, they're all made in China, models with the lithium iron phosphate batteries. And given that you're only importing them from China rather than all the way from the US, it's a big ask in terms of price, and probably the reason why, and it's probably the biggest barrier in terms of buying like an EV in Australia, is most people can't justify the cost. So in terms of my budget, I am going to go for just the standard range plus, but I will go through the features onto the website, and I'll have a chat about why I'm choosing that one, mainly because that's what I've got to use. And unfortunately, in Australia, you do have a little something called the luxury car tax. So it's luxury car tax in Australia. Caps up at 68,000 Australian dollars, but for EVs, it caps out at 77,000 Australian dollars. And after that point, you pay an extra 30%, 33% in tax on top of what you're paying. So I'm trying to actually go underneath that cap and avoid that. And I will talk about that later. So in terms of the Model 3, we're expecting a 9 to 12 week estimated delivery, and that's because Australia doesn't get a lot of shipments in. I do know that a recent shipment came in probably about a month or two ago, so maybe they have inventory stocked and might get a bit earlier. Let's see how we go. The first things first. So I'm coming from like an old Mazda 3, so these specs here are fantastic in comparison to my old Mazda. So 508 kilometer range. Remember, this is NEDC range, aka the fantastical never to be rich range. I don't know why Australia only reports in this range here. It would be nice if they use the the WLTP or the EPA rated range, which is closer to the expected range in real world. So I'm expecting when I get this car, I probably say probably about 400 kilometers, which is enough for mine uses. And I drive a lot more than your standard Australian driver. I probably drive 2 to 3 times more than your average driver. So if I can make this work, pretty much anyone can make this car work. 225, you're never going to reach that speed in Australia. Like speed like maxes out in most roads in Australia at 110, and we really enforce speeding fines over here, and they will cost you a lot of money and it's a lot of demerit points. So we don't really tend to speed, or well, not speed in front of the actual cameras. And so I would never even get to that range, that speed limit. So I'm not too concerned with that. 5.6, that is going to be a massive improvement on my current car. I'm actually going to sell my current car. That's because it's dying and I really need an upgrade. Personally, I would have liked to get a Model Y, but I doubt that that will launch in Australia within the next year or two, and I need a car now. So this is the 2021 model car, and this is with the refresh. So if you go through here, so you've got the chrome, the elite, the brand new lights, the motorized hatchback rear that comes off, and also the increase, the updated interior, so vegan leather, updated console, and you've got the standardized heat pump as normal. So if you've got the Standard Range Plus, so you can also get the long range and the performance. As you see, the prices do tend to hike up straight away, and as you can see, this is what it's listed at. Those ranges, take that with a pinch of salt. The performance, I'm expecting to just live up to its name. And the speeds, well, you're never really going to use the speed, maybe onto the track, maybe. So these prices do jump up. I would have loved to afford the long range, but unfortunately, it's not within budget, and it will go up above the luxury car tax, and I'd rather not pay the extra couple of thousand dollars that's going to add on top of the vehicle. So we're just going to go with the pearl white multicoat. So that's the base, paint color. I've actually seen a lot of these cars with this paint color, and I really do like it. It's great that you do get the multicoat because you're getting an extra layer of coat at the base price. Any other coat will cost you more. So things like solid black, which is your basic solid black, and you don't get that mirror pearl finish. You're paying $1,500 for that. $1,500 for the blue, but the blue is really nice. I wouldn't have mind to get the blue, but as I said, budget can only go so far. And the red just looks absolutely spectacular. I've seen this in the wild, and I would have loved to get it, but I'm not paying like $2,900 for it. So, in terms of the wheels, we're going to go with the 18-inch wheels. 18-inch wheels, perfectly suitable. It's larger than the tires on my current car, so it's definitely an upgrade. Also, if you do select the 19-inch wheels, that's an extra 2,200 upgrade. But also, for the 9-inch wheels, you are going to have a reduction in the cost of No, the efficiency of the car. So you are going to improvise your range if you do get the larger tire, but I want as much range as I can get. And you can see the price spike up. But what I'm going to do is we're going to go down and discover the pearl white. So still 71,996. Hey, interior, we're gonna go with all black. I wanna see how this goes. I do like the black better than the white. The white seats, I know that people say they're easy to clean, but I do know that white leather does age over time and starts to go that orangey brand towny color over time. These cars haven't been out long enough, so we don't really know how they will look, but I've seen older Model S's and they do tend to look quite old and dated over time, and I don't want to be cleaning that, so I'm just going to do black. The only thing concerned I have with black is we live in Australia, and Australia is bloody hot pretty much all year round. I know that the glass roof is treated for ultraviolet and infrared, so it holds up much of the heat, but if you've ever parked your car in the middle of an Australian summer, this thing's going to feel just like a furnace. But the thing is, because you can regulate the temperature of the car from the app, like before you get in, that's something I'll be doing, something to cool down the car. I'll see how I go. It might be the case that I might have to buy like a heat shield for the roof or whatever, but we'll see how we go. All right, so this is the big contentious thing. Full self-driving. Okay. Personally, I don't believe the value proposition of full self-driving is fully realized yet, so I'm not going to buy it. The good news is if you buy it in Australia, it is a lot cheaper than I'm buying in the US. So I think it is $10,000 at the moment. So we're getting a lot cheaper than our American brethren. But however, I don't think these features at the moment are worth the value, and I do believe a lot of people agree with me, mainly because they're pretty much half baked, and regardless of what Elon says, some of these don't really work too well. And also, I'm a bit concerned about the regulatory process in Australia. We're already behind in EVs and even far behind in terms of legislation and what they will allow onto the roads. So until that actually happens, and that might be 10, 15 years in the future, and I'm not only expecting maybe to keep this car for about 10 years, maybe if I can. So I don't think it's going to be worth the sell. I believe that this price is going up every single time, but we see how we go. Because at the moment, I've seen people who already have Navigate and Autopilot. It works considerably well. Autoed lane chain works fantastic, apparently. Auto park is a laughing joke, really. There's a reason why a lot of Tesla drivers don't use the auto park, and that's because it's terrible. I don't know why it's so terrible, because other manufacturers do it so well. Summon, that's a party trick. It sometimes works. I'd rather not have my really, really expensive vehicle drive like a 15-year-old on their piece. I'm not convinced on Summon. The full self-driving hardware, I am convinced that the hardware is there. To wherever Tesla will get the software up to scratch is another thing. And traffic light and stop sign control, that's a nice little thing. We'll likely see on how it goes, and obviously Autosteer on city streets. That's with the beta testing. So those guys who have been using the beta test, I've been watching those videos, and it seems to be a lot improved. But as I said, still not there. So I'm not going to add it. And one of the reasons why I'm not going to add it in at all is because it's going to push the value of the car above the luxury car tax limit. So the thing is, even if I change my mind, I can buy the car without adding this onto the cart, and I can buy it in the app after I purchase it, and I won't be slugged with that $3,000 to $4,000 in luxury car tax. So for those guys who are thinking of buying, definitely this. Also, I will throw my referral code on the screen. So if you're thinking about ordering a Tesla Model 3, or any other Tesla, please use my code. And so basically what you get at the moment, the referral code used to be really good. They used to give you extra stuff like power walls and brand new tires and hubs and all that stuff. Now it's pretty much just a free supercharging for 1500 kilometers. So basically the referral code that you use, they get 1500 and you get 1500 free supercharging bonus lasts for 15 no 6 months, so 6 months. So it's this is a little bonus for nothing. So I'll throw it on there, I'll throw it on the screen, and I'll throw it on the description below. So if you would like to use my code, please feel free. It would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, so we're going to move down, so we're not going to get that. So what we're going to do is we're going to continue payment. So yeah, it's pretty nerve-wracking that I'm going to order something that I've never seen before and I've never driven before, and estimated so this is continuing payment. So I can see here you can download the PDF. I'm assuming you can download the car like manual and all stuff. So what we're going to do is see how it's set to New South Wales. It won't let me change it for some reason. Anyway. Okay, so we're going to change it to Queensland because I'm actually in Queensland, and you will see the actual price drop from 72,000 all the way down to 70,497. And the reason why that is my local state government actually has a bit of a subsidies for EVs. So one of the actual taxes that you pay on top of the car, on top of GST, is stamp duty. So stamp duty is another tax that you mainly pay on things like cars and houses in Australia. EVs have a reduced stamp duty on so you pay less in stamp duty. And also in Queensland, you do get decrease registration fees for EVs. So I think I'm paying half the actual cost for the registration on this for a 12-month period. So it's normally about 750 for like a normal car in Australia. In terms of the reg, I think I'm paying like $350 or something. So that's what's bringing the actual price down. So that's why there's a price difference there. If you change it to the other state, so I think the cheapest state is the ACT because they don't pay any stamp duty at all, and you can see the price drop down to 69,774. And I think the most expensive, probably Victoria. I think the Victorians will pay more. There we go, 72,262. So yeah, being a former Victorian, I can feel your pain. So anyway, so we're going to get back to Queensland. So what you get in the car is your standard range plus. You get the pearl white paint, 18-inch aero wheels, which are those wheels there. All black, partial premium interior. So I think the only difference in the full premium and the partial premium is you get floor mats and you get halo running interior lights inside the car. For all of those things, I can live without. I've actually already ordered floor mats from overseas, so they're on their way. There seems to be a low, there's a shortage of the actual floor mats in Australia, so you actually can't even order them from the Tesla website at the moment. So I'm not going to bother. So this is your standard autopilot, which is basically your lane keep assist and your adaptive cruise control, which I'm perfectly happy with. I'm a person who drives a lot. I actually like driving, so it's pretty good. So we're going to show the actual details on here. So this is the actual breakdown of the car. So it's 99, so 66,999, no, 66,900. To remember, that also includes your GST cost. In that case, your delivery fee, regardless of which you order, it's going to be 1,375. Your order fee is when you order the car. You will. This is a non-refundable $150 deposit. So remember, if you order this car here, make sure that you have it configured the way that you want, because you aren't going to get that money back once you press the submit button. As I said, local stamp duty is to produce on this vehicle, so I'm only paying 13.7. So, for example, if I switch that to New South Wales, you will see that spike up to stamp duty of $2,500 in Queensland, we pay less. And also we have a reduced local registration. This is your local third party, like compulsory third party insurance. That's if you hit your car and you cause damage to people and other property, so that's going to cover you. That's a requirement in Australia. So when you get your vehicle registered, you will have to pay that price here. It's a local plate fee, it's only $30. So yep, so on road costs, you're looking at slightly over $2,000 and a driveway price of $7,497. So the estimated fuel costs and expected to save is $5,600. That's for average driving. I drive a lot more than that. So I'm expecting my fuel costs. And one of the reasons why I'm buying this car is because I drive so much, I spend so much on petrol and servicing with my current car that, I will save money in terms of running cost and maintenance. Basically servicing, I was like an actual nightmare with my last car. So if you're planning on getting like a Tesla or a car, remember it is a depreciable asset. If you're buying a car as an investment, it is a poor financial choice. If you have that much money, you can probably buy property, buy land, invest in a hedge fund. There's 100 things that you can do with it. Buying a car is a silly idea, and I already know that, but what I'm planning on saving is the actual running cost and the actual fuel cost. So car, bad investment as a depreciable asset, but any car that you buy, unless you're buying a collectible vehicle, that's just the way it's gonna be. So just expect that at all. In terms of saving, so I'm gonna pay it in cost in full. I'm not gonna take out a loan, and as I said, due today, is $150 Australian dollars. And there we go. So what you do is you go into order with card, and it will bring you up to another screen, I believe. Let's see if my internet is working. Oh, here we go. Yep. Actually, yep. So, so basically, due date. You can order with a card. So that's basically just. I just realized that it's scrolled on even further. So you can either wire transfer or you can pay with a card. So this is where you enter your personal details. So first name, last name, email address. And then you put your card details in, billing information, I'll change it later. And then you just place your order. Okay, so I'm gonna leave the video at that. And then I'm gonna chase up this video with my updated delivery and see when Tesla contacts me. So super exciting. Can't believe I'm doing this, but yeah, I've been like a excited little kid outside a chocolate shop staring in, trying not to lick the window every time I see one of these cars around. Obviously this is above what most people can afford, and I believe this is a problem. I believe Tesla should be like focusing their energies on getting the price down, because once these vehicles get to a price that most Australians can afford, this industry is going to explode, and I believe that's going to be the case. I'm super excited. So it's pretty much a waiting game. So I'll throw my details and I will throw my referral code on the screen, and I would leave it in the description below. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. As always, you know, proven usual good stuff, like, comment and subscribe, leave me a question, probably post down how much the Tesla free standard range plus costs in your country. I'll be very curious. I feel sorry for those guys in New Zealand, because I know that they have got a 50% GST, and I believe their tariffs, and because their currency is a lot lower than Australia. I don't know how much it is going to be in New Zealand. I can probably look it up, but anyway, just leave us a comment. As always, smash that notification bell. I will be posting a lot more videos on this once I get the car. Probably do a video on my delivery experience, but super exciting. Now it's just a waiting game, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Random Geek out. Cheers, guys. Bye.